Solvent casting explained. Solvent casting can be used to replace the mechanical mixing of an extruder screw and obtain homogeneous mixtures on a molecular level. A stable residual solvent-free amorphous solid dispersion is formed in the final fusion-based step via vacuum compression molding. It is recommended for total quantities below 100 mg of material. The beauty of it is that quantities as little as 1 mg are obtainable via this method, making it suitable for work on new chemical entities. Let us show you the melt prep approach to thin film solvent casting. Take the ingredients and prepare stock solutions in desired concentrations. Prepare the required mixture. Mix the solution on a vortex mixer and obtain a fully transparent solution. Dilute with solvents if necessary. Transfer the solution onto a flat glass plate and spread it into a thin layer. The thinner the layer, the faster the drying and the more uniform the resulting film. Remove the residual with a razor blade. If the residuals break into tiny splinters, try warming the plate up slightly in an oven. Do not worry if the film turns opaque. In many cases, this is only temporary. Fusion-based ASDs, as we obtained via VCM, are more stable. Collect the residuals and load them into the VCM tool. Assemble the chamber with the main body and lid. Run the VCM process. The vacuum removes the residual solvents, and subsequent heating will initiate melting. A homogeneous melt is obtained within minutes. The last step, cooling, solidifies the ASD. Once the sample preparation is completed, extract the sample. If larger quantities of the formulation are needed for dissolution testing as the project progresses, cryogenic milling can be a valuable solution. It allows for processing up to 5 grams with even the smallest cryogenic mills. We also have a dedicated video on this topic. Check out our knowledge base for more information.